Hey, good morning, how do you do? We've got something special for you. It's just for fun, it's just for kids. It's time for the Sippy Touching.
All right, number six, the results are in from the 2024 World Happiness Report. Finland, once again, topping this year's list of happiest countries in the world.
The Finns.
Experts say Finland is the type of place where wallets are returned to the owners if they're dropped in the street. It also has universal health care and more education opportunities for all people. So everyone more or less comes out of the starting gate the same place. In second place, Denmark, followed by Iceland and Sweden.
Mm. Good for them.
Yeah.
Did I hear you say, ich, the Finns?
Finns.
They're always winning. You know, how about an underdog? Someone comes up that you don't expect on that list. All of a sudden, they're really happy. Yeah.
Those domineering Finns. You hear people tell that all the time.
All right, number five, next time you're at a hotel breakfast buffet, you might want to avoid the eggs.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, culinary experts say they're usually just fine to eat.
Oh,
they just don't taste very good. That's because most hotels rely on the old powdered eggs or the old liquid egg products.
I don't want to know.
They also contain extra additives and preservatives that you really don't need. Not only that, they're almost always prepared in advance, sometimes in a microwave, and usually reheated several times before reaching your plate. The experts say you're better off with fruit, the old packaged cereals, croissants, oatmeal, or yogurt.
Yeah.
Hey, it's almost like you don't want to know. Wait, you eat what you want.
Yeah.
Number four, they're calling this the Skytanic.
Sign me up.
Oh, it's great marketing.
Yeah.
The world's largest plane. Engineers just released plans for the Windrunner.
Ooh.
It's impossible to crash. It's designed to deliver blades for large wind turbines.
What mountain in front of me?
They're too big to be transported by road. The plane would be nearly as long as a regulation football field. If all goes as planned, Windrunner would become a reality in 4 years.
Yeah.
Hold your breath.
Mm-hmm. All right, number three. You want to save time getting dressed in the morning?
Yeah.
Try sandwich dressing.
All right.
It's simple. You use two matching elements on the top and the bottom of your outfit.
What?
So the top and bottom have matching elements, and then you add a filler in the middle. It's basically a cute top sandwich.
Oh, okay.
Okay, look at actress Michelle Yeoh.
Look
where
at
is she?
Her.
Where?
We
That's
saw
not her.
She was like the first
I don't know what she was wearing.
She'll
she
come
had,
back.
Okay,
she had a sandwich on.
She had a bright yellow top on, and then bright yellow on the bottom, and then a neutral.
That's how you do it.
Skirt in the middle?
Yeah.
Well, what was on the bottom if it wasn't the skirt?
I'm not getting this.
I'm confused now.
The sandwich.
Oh, wait, there. She is. Okay, so she has a brown skirt.
She's talking about the shoes.
Oh, so top and shoes are the same, and then you have a neutral in the middle. Well, that didn't simplify anything for me.
No, it didn't.
More complicated because I can't figure it out. So you should just match your shoes to your outfit.
To your top.
To your top.
That was big with the ladies in the day. Like, my mother will not leave the house without her shoes and her perch matching.
Well,
that's a whole nother level of
the way it should be.
Thinking that I can't get into. Yeah. I can't
matching.
Be doing. Matching the purse to the shoes.
That's hard?
It's a lot. No, how many purses do you have that match a pair of yellow shoes if you want to throw in yellow?
A lot.
And it seems like you're a try-hard.
Yeah.
Well,
as Larry
your mom's always been a try-hard.
Yeah.
It's the one thing they've always said about her.
Yes.
Yeah.
At D.
Yeah, she's trouble.
What a tryhard. Same with your dad also.
He's very try.
That was her nickname, the old tryhard bongo.
Yeah. Yeah. All right.
Number two.
Yeah. All right, time
he
for
likes
number
to leave
two.
It sick.
I thought you were, I thought he was confused.
No, yeah. Post-it notes are going to turn 50 this year. They almost didn't make it. Back in 1968, a scientist named Spencer Silver discovered a new type of adhesive, and he had no idea how to use it. Then the idea went on the back burner for years until 1974. Then a guy named Art Fry was singing at church and he wanted a stick-on bookmark that could be used with the hymnal without causing any damage. Mm. So Fry worked with Silver to develop some prototypes. Eventually they came up with the old Post-it. So happy birthday to the Post-it. Right. No, 50 big ones.
But I think that the inventors didn't make the money on it. It was the company.
You gotta be.
You think if you'd go the extra mile, they'd throw a little something your way.
Yeah, you think the corporate executives would appreciate the workers. You'd think that, wouldn't you?
Different day.
Yeah.
That's why you gotta go out on your own. You got a good idea. You go tell the man to go blow it. I'm gonna turn this thing on my own. That's the American way.
Yeah.
Number one, we're looking at things that people in the 50s and 60s thought would be true today, but are not. Back then, they thought TV dinners would make traditional cooking obsolete. Here's a TV dinner commercial from 1955.
Say, you gals think you're lucky you can get Swanson TV turkey dinners, but I say Swanson TV turkey dinners are a bigger break for husbands. Now, you take me. I can be early, I can be late, I can bring pals to dinner anytime I please, and get this, my wife never panics. She just takes Swanson TV turkey dinners from the freezing compartment of our refrigerator when I'm a little off schedule.
Oh.
And right you are, Jack.
Oh.
And that is because Mary Lou knows that she can have a swell dinner ready in just 25 minutes.
Right.
And talk about easy. Well, she just pops Swanson TV turkey dinners in a hot oven. You know, they're oven ready in individual heat and serve trays.
I didn't know.
With Swanson TV turkey dinners, you just heat and serve, and you serve big and hearty slices of moist, tender Swanson turkey with grand giblet gravy and special cornbread dressing and fluffy whipped sweet potatoes with golden Swanson butter.
Men. Of course, if we're at a bourbon, Mary Lou has a real problem.
Yeah.
And Mary Lou better have her best pearls and high heels on when I come home from work. I don't want her looking sloppy when I bring the boys over.
Anytime. I'm glad they weren't pandering by hiring a female actress to do that commercial, right?
Oh, that was great. All right, so that's the six.